and dear ones? These beliefs, upon what are they founded? Are they founded upon any reality at all? And we say, dear ones, yes. Yes, they are. The reality that founds the belief of a judge is only your consciousness, only the mind that exists within your field of consciousness. It is a belief, dear ones, that you hold within yourself, that you express into this world, and that this world resonates back to you, creating equilibrium amongst what you express and what you receive, creating balance within the vibrational harmony that exists within consciousness. So, dear ones, what you believe is creating your reality. There is no being telling you that you need forgiveness other than yourself, other than those people you choose to surround yourself in. Know this, dear ones, that you are the judge of yourself, and that the world only responds in resonant harmony with that which you are continually creating in your vibrational field. Continual creation, dear one, not separate creation. For you do not have impulses, you do not have separate thoughts that span out from your vibrational being into the world around you, thinking it on again, off again, like pulses, like rhythms, like lights, on, off, manifest, not manifest, manifest, not manifest. And you, dear ones, who believe yourself to be separate, think that you are only manifesting when you choose to believe in your mind that you are manifesting and sending out your thoughts. Yet, dear ones, you are not separate. You are always in communication, even if you are living as an unconscious being. During your periods of unconsciousness, when you think yourself to exist only as the thoughts occurring within your head, know, dear one, that all of life around you is resonating with this, with these thoughts that only you think you can hear, with your private thoughts, and with all of your vibrational field. The world is always in resonant harmony with you. There is no separate times. There is only this moment, with forms occurring within this moment, continually changing, continually adapting to all the vibration that is existing within consciousness. All the vibration, dear one, that is part of one vibrational field that is creating this world. Again, dear ones, the vibrations of all form are not separate occurrences. It is one vibrational field with many frequencies of vibration existing within it. For it is, dear ones, the one consciousness vibrating into life all of manifest creation, all of the manifest forms. Now, dear ones, seeing this, knowing that all of life is one being, one consciousness, one vibration, seeing, dear ones, that there is no separation existing outside of your concepts that you are a separate being. There is no separation. So, dear ones, who is there to judge? Who is there to say you do wrong? For you may hold the belief that there is some being existing outside of creation, condemning you, judging each and every action. And this being, dear ones, does not exist within this world. and look around you, dear ones. Have you met this being? Do you know this being that is creating all of life? And dear ones, what you see as life, what you see as oneness, can this at all be separate from the Creator, from the creating force? We ask you, dear ones, to look upon life from your experience, beyond your thinking mind, from your experience as consciousness, as a conscious being, aware of your thoughts, aware of this body, aware of this world, aware of life itself. Exist here, momentarily. Exist here, and where is the judge? Exist here, and what else exists besides perfect peace? Besides unconditional love? Simply remain as you are, and you will know love. You will know peace, and you will not find a judge. For dear ones, in all sincerity, we tell you that only you judge yourself. You do not see the animal kingdom taking up cruel punishment upon themselves, forcing themselves not to eat, for they feel bad about taking food. You do not see the animal kingdom, dear ones, forcing themselves into slavery, for they believe themselves to be unworthy. Dear ones, look around you, and what do you see? Does this reality that you see conform to the beliefs within your mind? Or does instead, dear ones, the reality become that which you think it is? For dear ones, many of you hold false concepts of who you think you are, of what you think life is. And you, dear ones, live in a state of constant suffering as you continually judge yourself, as you continually think yourself unworthy from some imaginary figure, some being that you have never met, yet some being that you have been told exists. Yet we ask you, dear ones, of those that tell you of this judge, have they ever seen it? With their own eyes, with their own soul, have they ever experienced? Has they ever seen this judge? We realize, dear ones, that many of you have built your idea of who you think you are upon this belief of a judging being, upon this belief of a judging God. We do not judge you, dear ones. We do not say you are wrong to hold this belief, for we allow you the freedom to create your reality as a living soul, as a form in consciousness. Yet we tell you, dear ones, if you continue to create based upon the belief of a separate self, based upon the belief of a separate world, based upon the belief of a separate God, you will only find yourself feeling this separation, experiencing this separation, knowing personal suffering.